Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, a researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today, I want to talk about how eating habits might cause diabetes. After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. Can eating habits cause diabetes? Well, that's a question researchers seem to be debating, but the consensus is that yes, it can cause diabetes. Now, not everyone who has diabetes has it because of their eating habits. Some people are predisposed to diabetes, and no matter what or how they eat, they are going to have it. But for others, what you eat can possibly lead to type 2 diabetes. One possible contributing factor to type 2 diabetes is our society's hurried pace. This has led us to rely a great deal on fast foods. I was able to find several studies to say that fast food consumption can further the development of type 2 diabetes. A 2013 study published in the European Journal of Nutrition set out to clarify the role of dietary patterns in the onset of type 2 diabetes in overweight people. The study found that diets high in soft drinks and French fries, low in fruit and vegetables, were associated with a great risk of type 2, especially in overweight participants, particularly among those who are less physically active. A 2005 study published in Lancet concluded that fast food consumption has a strong positive correlation with weight gain and insulin resistance, implying that fast food intake may promote obesity and type 2 diabetes. A 2013 review published in the Current Opinion in Clinical Nutrition and Metabolic Care notes that high sugar diets not only promote weight gain but insulin resistance, which leads to a predisposition for type 2 diabetes. In addition, the review notes that having type 2 diabetes significantly increases the risk of developing Alzheimer's disease. The researchers concluded that dietary modifications can greatly reduce the risk of both type 2 and Alzheimer's. A 2001 study published in Diabetologia notes that it may be more important to focus on the quality of the fats and carbs consumed rather than the amount alone to prevent type 2 diabetes. High intake of trans fatty acids, saturated fats, and refined carbohydrates, as well as other processed foods, increase the risk for type 2, whereas whole grains, polyunsaturated fats, fiber-rich foods, omega-3 fatty acids, and others minimally processed foods can lower the risk. Poor diet can be categorized by more than simply eating unhealthy foods. Breakfast is an important meal that, when missed, can result in health consequences. A 2012 study published by the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that skipping breakfast increased the risk of type 2 diabetes, even after adjusting for body mass index. Snacking between meals were also found to increase type 2. Our highly civilized society has taken away much of the nutrition from many foods. We have taken the bran out of flour. We eat mostly refined sugar and processed foods. This has certainly contributed to an obese society and one which a high population is found of diabetes. Many a renowned researcher holds the belief that a deficiency in vitamin B6 in our diet may also be a cause of diabetes. Lack of vitamin B causes the transformation of tryptophan, an amino acid present in our diet, into xanthuronic acid, which harms the beta cells of the pancreas to cause diabetes. Some researchers believe that diabetes arises not because of inheriting defective chromosome, but because of genetically determined excessive requirements of vitamin B6. Of course, further research and investigations are called to validate this belief. Diabetes due to unhealthy eating habits is becoming a common crisis among urban dwellers, with multinational companies promoting ready-to-eat processed foods and their range of fast food range, people are getting addicted to a lifestyle that is prone to high risks of diabetes. The most troubling phenomena in this trend is young people becoming obese. This new phenomenon is being called diabesity. It's a major health hazard that leads to diabetes and other chronic health diseases that plague people with unhealthy eating habits. Other factors of unhealthy eating include snacking. No matter how healthy you are, there will be some sort of craving for snacks. During such times, snacking on artificially sweetened snacks, deep-fried snacks, instead of snacks like fruits, result in a diabetic risk. Carbonated, sugary, and caffeine drinks that are popular, well, those are being consumed during snack times and even at meals, and it's highly unhealthy. It can cause health risks such as obesity and put you in direct risk of type 2. Ignoring fruits and vegetables is a major problem. They are rich in sources of nutrition and fibers that help your body in both sugar control and proper digestion. Ignoring them causes an imbalance in sugar levels in your body, develops a risk of diabetes. So is snacking in odd hours. We should be snacking on healthy foods. That becomes a good habit. However, munching on packed foods and other unhealthy options during odd hours like midnight strains your digestive system and spikes sugar levels. In today's busy and stressful lifestyle, people are prone to emotional stress. This results in emotional eating, and overeating causing erratic weight gains and obesity, putting your direct risk of diabetes due to improper sugar levels produced in your body. So, to answer the question, yes, our eating habits can certainly promote or even cause diabetes. Another contributing factor would be our lack of physical activity or our sedentary lifestyle. Don't forget to get my new ebook. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel for many videos like this in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.